गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हमें लास्ट क्लास रे अप टू इक्विवर केमिकल इक्वेशन पर्यंत डिस्कशन करथिले। तो आज से केमिकल इक्वेशन अपन स्टार्ट करते। व्हाट इज केमिकल इक्वेशन? केमिकल इक्वेशन व्हेन ए केमिकल रिएक्शन When a chemical reaction is represented by using symbols and formulae, then it is called chemical equation. When chemical reaction is written in terms of symbols and formulae, suppose I say when ethane C2H6, this is your ethane, undergoes oxidation, it gives carbon dioxide and water like this. When H2 react with N2, it gives ammonia NH3 like this. These are chemical equations. As these are written, the chemical reaction is written in terms of chemical. When the chemical reaction is represented by using formulae and symbols, then it is called chemical equation. Now, chemical equations are of two types. One is balanced chemical equation, balanced chemical equation. Another one is imbalanced chemical equation. Balanced chemical equation and imbalanced chemical equation. So, which one is balanced chemical equation? When both the atoms or all the atoms on both sides of reaction, when all the atoms on both sides of chemical reactions are same. Suppose there is a carbon here, left side, reactant side, this side is called reactant and this side is called product side. When all the atoms on both sides are same, then it is called chemical, then it is called balanced chemical equation. If you say, if you see here, suppose carbon is 2, here carbon is 1. Hydrogen 6, here hydrogen is 2. Oxygen 2, here hydrogen is 3. So this is not balanced. Now, which is balanced chemical equation? When all the atoms on both sides are same, then it is called balanced chemical equation. If you say H2 plus N2 gives NH3, if you put 2 here, then nitrogen becomes same, 2, 2, and hydrogen 6, if you balance here, then 3H2. Now 3H2 plus 3H2 means 6 hydrogen, 2 ammonia means 6 hydrogen, 2 nitrogen, 2 nitrogen. So it is balanced chemical equation. So what is balanced chemical equation? When all the atoms on both sides are same, then it is called balanced chemical equation. And if any one of the atoms on both sides are not same, then it is called imbalanced chemical equation. So according to law of conservation of mass, means the mass before reaction must be equal to mass after reaction. So according to law of conservation of mass, all chemical reactions should be balanced. All chemical equations should be balanced according to law of conservation of mass, which is the mass before reaction must be equal to mass after reaction. So total mass remain unchanged. That is called law of conservation of mass. Okay, now we'll see how we balance a chemical equation. Chemical equation can be balanced by 5 methods. First one is heat and trial method. Second one is partial equation method. Third one is algebraic method fourth one is ion electron method and fifth one is oxidation number method. These are the methods for balancing a chemical equation. Now in this chapter we will only discuss about heat and dry method. Okay, now this is heat and trial method, HIT, not HEAT, heat and trial method. Heat means put any number before the reactant or product. Suppose I say C6H6 plus O2 gives CO2 plus H2O. This is your equation. We have to balance it by heat and trial method. What are the steps of balancing equation by heat and trial method? First, we have to put numbers, suitable numbers, before the reactant or product. And we have to take trial whether all the atoms on both sides are same or not. This process continues. If not same, then put another number and take trial. If not same, then put another number, then take trial. This process continues till all the atoms on both sides become same. And at that time it is called balanced chemical equation. So suppose we will put 6 here, then carbon becomes same. Now hydrogen here 6, here 2, so put 3 here. Now hydrogen becomes same, 6. Now what is the number of oxygen? 12, this is 3, 15. So let it 15 by 2 O2. This is balanced chemical equation, or you can write 2C6H6 plus 15 O2 gives 12 CO2 plus 6 H2O. Now this chemical equation is balanced chemical equation according to heat and trial method. So we have to put numbers and take trials whether all the atoms on both sides are same or not. Now new chapter will discuss about molecular mass. Suppose I say, I'll ask a question to any student, what is your weight? He or she may say, I'm 40 kg. What do you mean by 40 kg? How you know your weight is 40 kg? You are weighing, you are measuring it in weighing machine. Means what? Your weight is 40 times heavier than 1 kg weight. If you take a physical balance and put a substance one side and put 1 kg weight in another side, if 10 1 kg weight becomes same with that substance, then that substance weight is 10 kg. If 20, then it is 20 kg. If 30, then it is 30 kg. Similarly, molecular mass is first determined. So what is molecular mass? It is the relative mass of one molecule of any substance, one molecule of any substance to the mass of one atom of hydrogen. So mass of one molecule of any substance divided by mass of one atom of hydrogen, this one is molecular mass. molecular mass equal to mass of one molecule of any substance, mass of one molecule of any substance divided by mass of one atom of hydrogen, or you can write equal to mass of one molecule of any substance divided by 1/12 of an atom of C6-12 means गोटे हाइड्रोजन एटम संगे कंपेयर करिबा जहा वन ता हाइड्रोजन एटम संगे कंपेयर करिबा जहा वन ता कार्बन एटम रो 1/12 पार्ट संगे भी कंपेयर करिबा से या बिकॉज कार्बन रो मास हम जानि छ 12 तार 1/12 जदि हम कर देई कैंसिल होला वन मींस हाइड्रोजन एटम संगे कंपेयर करिबा जहा गोटे कार्बन एटम रो 1/12 पार्ट संगे कंपेयर करिबा सेम कथा So, molecular mass equal to mass of one molecule of any substance divided by mass of one atom of a hydrogen or mass of one molecule of any substance divided by 1/12 of the mass of an atom of carbon. Now, what is the unit of molecular mass? The unit of molecular mass is AMU. Unit of molecular mass is AMU, that is atomic mass unit. This is the unit of molecular mass. So AMU, atomic mass unit. Previously another unit was used, that is called CU. Now this unit is not used generally, CU, that is carbon unit, because at that time scientists used carbon atom for comparing the molecular mass. So CU, another unit was used, that is carbon unit. Now AMU is generally used, that is atomic mass unit. For example, molecular mass of, suppose I say molecular mass of H2SO4, if you say equal to two hydrogen, so 2 × hydrogen mass is 1 plus sulfur is 32 plus oxygen 4 × 16 equal to 2 plus 32 plus 64 equal to 98 AMU. This is the molecular mass of H2SO4, because molecular mass of H2SO4 is 98 AMU. By adding the atomic mass of all the atoms, we get molecular mass, which is 98 AMU. Similarly, say another example, what is the molecular mass of glucose? C6H12O6 is the glucose, and the molecular mass is 6 × 12 + 12 + 6 × 16, which is equal to 72 + 12 + 96, which is equal to 180 AMU. This is the molecular mass of glucose. In the same way, you can calculate all the molecular mass of any substance, or you can calculate the molecular mass of any molecule. Now we will discuss how molecular mass is determined. Determination of molecular mass. Determination of molecular mass. Molecular mass can be determined by three processes. First one is gram molecular volume method, gram molecular volume method. Second one is vapor density method, vapor density method, and third one is Victor Mayer method. Victor Mayer's method. These are the three methods by which we can determine or calculate molecular mass. First one is gram molecular volume method or short reaction ko hazard GMV method. Gram molecular volume method or GMV method. We'll discuss gram molecular volume method. In this method, we have to remember that the molecular mass of any gas, in this method, the molecular mass of gas can be determined. So, what is this method? 22.4 liter or 22400 ml. 22.4 liter jaha 22400 ml se hai. 22.4 liter or 22400 ml of any gas at NTP. 22.4 liter or 22400 ml of any gas at NTP weighs equal to its molecular mass. This is your GMV method. 22.4 liter of any gas, whatever may be the gas, hydrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, methane, you can say any gas. 22.4 liter or 22400 ml of any gas at NTP condition. What is NTP condition? Now NTP condition is temperature should be 0 degree Celsius or 273 Kelvin and pressure is 760 millimeter or 1 atm atmospheric pressure. So in this condition, that is temperature and pressure at these conditions, this is the NTP condition. At these conditions, 22.4 liter or 22400 ml of any gas weighs equal to its molecular mass. Suppose I am giving you an example. Suppose John Loco एपटे जाउची से गोटे बेलून रे गोटे गैस आनी के हमकू देई गले पहले टेक दिस गैस एंड सेल मी व्हाट इज द मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ द गैस इनसाइड द बेलून गोटे बेलून ले गैस दे के हमकू बोले पहले एही गैस रो मॉलिक्यूलर मास के कैलकुलेट करो आमे फर्स्ट ए रूम को सपोज एनटीपी कंडीशन को कन्वर्ट करिबा. एनटीपी कंडीशन ता कोन ना टेंपरेचर 273 केल्विन और 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सपोज ए रूम को टेंपरेचर को रूम टेंपरेचर को 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस कर देले आ प्रेशर को ए रूम रो प्रेशर को सपोज 760 एमएम और 1 एटीएम को कन्वर्ट कर देले ता पर याकू वेट करिबा तले एटी कोन कोन रहला बेलून प्लस गैस प्लस थ्रेड सुता जो बंधा है तो थ्रेड सपोज टोटल टाइम वेट कर देले हम पाई गले गोटे वेट तापर गैस को खोली दबा एबे ओनली बेलून प्लस थ्रेड बेलून प्लस थ्रेड रहला यार वेट पाई गले तापर एठो याकु माइनस करतले आमे गैस रो वेट मिलि गला. सपोज एतिकी गैस रो वेट सपोज दिस गैस इज 2 लीटर बैलून 2 लीटर गैस रो वेट एनटीपी कंडीशन रे आमे पाइले एतिकी তাহলে 22.4 লিটার গ্যাস অফ ওয়েট কেটে ক্যালকুলেট করতে দেওয়া বাই ইউনিটারি মেথড দিস ইজ দা মলিকুলার মাস অফ দা গ্যাস সাপোজ আই সে অ্যান एग्जांपल সাপোজ দা কোশ্চেন ইজ 3 লিটার অফ এ গ্যাস এট এনটিপি ওয়েট 9.6 gram. Find molecular mass. Find molecular mass of gas. This is your question. 3 liter of gas at NTP with 9.6 gram. Find molecular mass of the gas. This is the question. How can we solve it? 3 liter of gas with 9.6 gram, 3 liter of gas weighs 9.6 gram because NTP condition is given. 3 liter weighs 9.6 gram. So 22.4 liter weighs how much gram? This is the answer. So solution, how can we write solution? 3 liter of a gas at NTP weighs 9.6 gram. So 22.4 liter of gas at NTP weighs 9.6 divided by 3 into 22.4. Now cancel for 3.2. Now this is 22.4 into 3.2. Now this becomes answer. This much AMU multiply 3.2 into 22.4, which is equal to the molecular mass of that gas. This type. And another question I will ask, another question we will discuss. Suppose in ml the mass is given in ml. Suppose I say 300 ml or 500 ml of a gas at NTP. NTP condition must be given. 500 ml of gas at NTP weighs suppose 4.5 gram. Find molecular mass of gas. Now solution. 500 ml of gas at NTP weighs 4.5 gram. Now 22400 ml, 22.4 liter or 22400 ml of gas at NTP weighs 4.5 divided by 500 into 22400. Now cancel it. 0.9 equal to 0.9 into 224 equal to this much AMU answer. This is the molecular mass of that gas. This is your GMV method, gram molecular volume method. You can calculate the molecular mass of any gas by this method, by this way. Second one is vapor density method or VD method. Vapor density method or VD method. What is vapor density first? Vapor density is mass of certain volume of gas at NTP divided by mass of same volume of hydrogen at NTP. सपोज सही जेमिति एग्जांपल कहिदिली जणे लोक आसीले हमको गोटे बैलून रे सपोज दिस इज योर बैलून एमके गोटे गैस पैक कर देले गैस नहीं गैस चलती गैस दे गेले पहिले एही गैस रो वेपर डेंसिटी कैलकुलेट करो आ मॉलिक्युलर मास कैलकुलेट करो तले फर्स्ट दिस इज योर सपोज 5 लीटर वेसल 5 लीटर बैलून फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड द mass of only gas present inside the 5 liter balloon jen ki fast kole balloon plus gas plus thread tar weight calculate kar dele tar gas ko open kar dele only balloon aur thread aur mass nele jeti ke la minus kar do that is the mass of only gas so mass of 5 liter of gas milgala एबे कोन करिबा ना सेही बैलून रे 5 लीटर हाइड्रोजन गैस पैक कर दवा जो गैस भी दिया है सब हमको फास्ट प्रूफ तार मास कैलकुलेट करले तापरे सेही बैलून रे सेति की हाइड्रोजन पैक कर देले जति की हाइड्रोजन थिला सेति की हाइड्रोजन ता भीतर पैक कर दवा तापरे हाइड्रोजन रो मास को पुनी कैलकुलेट कर देले एबे मास ऑफ any volume of gas at NTP divided by mass of that mass volume of hydrogen at NTP that is vapor density and after calculating vapor density we can get molecular mass as molecular mass equal to 2 into vapor density this is the formula molecular mass equal to 2 into vapor density so In this way, we can calculate molecular mass. Let us discuss another thing. Experimentally, it has been found that mass of 1 ml of hydrogen equal to at NTP, mass of 1 ml of hydrogen is equal to 0.000892 gram. This is the mass of 1 ml of hydrogen at NTP. 0.000892 gram, or this can be written as 0.00009 gram. By rounding of this one, we get 0.00009 gram. So mass of 1 liter of H2 at NTP equal to in 2000 equal to 0.09 gram. This is the mass of 1 liter of hydrogen and this is the mass of 1 ml of hydrogen. So by using this mass we can calculate vapor density. And see, this is a question. If 2 liter of an unknown gas weighs 2.5 gram, find molecular mass of gas by VD method. We have to calculate in VD method. Otherwise, you can also calculate by GMB method. Kemiti GMB method re karibo 2 liter gas ro weight 2.5 gram. To 22.4 liter gas ro weight kete calculate kar dele gelo. In the same way, vapor density method VD method re kemiti kariba dekho. 2 liter unknown gas ro weight 2.5 gram. Solution. Solution. 2 liter unknown gas weight 2.5 gram. So first we have to calculate 2 liter of what is the weight of 2 liter of hydrogen gas? we know 1 liter H2 at NTP equal to 0.09 gram. So 2 liter H2 at NTP was equal to 0.09 into 2 equal to 0.18 gram. This is the mass of 2 liter of hydrogen. This is the mass of 2 liter of unknown gas. So vapor density equal to Vd equal to mass of 2 liter of gas, that is 2.5 divided by mass of 2 liter of hydrogen, that is 0.18 equal to 250 by 18. Now molecular mass equal to two into Vd equal to 250 by 18 equal to, you can solve it, 2 point something, you can solve easily, 250 by 9, then you can get answer. This is your molecular mass by Vd method. And third method is Victor Mayer method. Victor Mayer's method. Victor Mayer's method. In this method, molecular mass of volatile substance is generally calculated. Volatile substance means which vaporize out at room temperature. So in Victor Mayer's method, we can calculate the molecular mass of volatile substance jo guriko room temperature re ape ape udi kina pade jay, they are called volatile substance. Au Victor Mayer method re ame volatile substance ro molecular mass ko calculate kariba. Suppose accurately weighed quantity of volatile substance is taken inside it. Kota vessel ne ame tar exact figure tumo course re nahi mu khali tumko bujheiba pai gote figure kahu kariki kahuchi. Accurately weighed quantity of volatile substance is taken in a vessel and by heating it we can get the volume of vapor formed from the volatile substance. Suppose aapko hame heat kare emiti ka volatile substance to room temperature mein vapor hi ki pade jaye ताकु जदि हमें हीट कर दबा सांगे सांगे वेपर इकी पड़े जीवो ताकु सपोज हमें इकी कलेक्शन करके रखि देले लेट इट बी VML एंड द मास ऑफ वोलेटाइल सब्सटेंस इज W ग्राम ऑफ वोलेटाइल सब्सटेंस इज टेकन इन अ बॉल और वेसल एंड हीट इट एंड वी गेट VML ऑफ एयर और एनी गैस evolved from this volatile substance. Now, how can we calculate molecular mass? This is your VML and this room temperature is suppose T degree Celsius, pressure equal to PMM and aqueous tension. Aqueous tension equal to AMM. So, tomo mind re question asibo, what is aqueous tension? Ethi ame heat kale etiki gram, W gram volatile substance ku heat kale, ethi volume produce hela, etiki air baharila, VML, etiki temperature T degree Celsius re, ei room ro suppose pressure samti PMM, equation sun actually kon na gote room bhitare ba gote vessel bhitare jeti ki water vapor achi mu jodi koibi ebe ei room ro ame pressure measure kariba pressure total pressure measure kar dele suppose pmm hela suppose 100 mm hela mu koibi ei room re ame jo uti bosi chu ei room re suppose pressure 100 mm hei chi ei room re kon water vapor nahi water vapor bi achi suppose water vapor mai pressure hela 5 mm एति जति की वाटर वेपर अछि ता पई प्रेशर हला 5 एमएम नाउ मु जदि कहबी तारे ड्राई एयर रो प्रेशर केते आबो ये हला टोटल प्रेशर ये हला ओनली वाटर वेपर पई प्रेशर ड्राई गैस रो प्रेशर दिस माइनस दिस इक्वल टू 95 एमएम नाउ दिस इज द ड्राई प्रेशर ड्राई एयर रो प्रेशर विदाउट वाटर वेपर ताले इक्वेशन सन हमें कहा को कहबा वाटर वेपर पाई जति की प्रेशर था ओनली वाटर वेपर पाई जति की प्रेशर ताकुई कहा जाए इक्वेशन सन सपोज इक्वेशन सन केते ना एमएम आउ पर कहती डब्ल्यू ग्राम वोलेटाइल सब्सटेंस नहीं छे ताकु हीट करले वीएमएल लो एयर आइला वीएमएल लो गैस प्रोड्यूस होला ए रूम रो टेंपरेचर सपोज 3 डिग्री सेल्सियस प्रेशर सपोज पीएमएम एंड इक्वेशन सन इज एएमएम एती की कथान को मिलिला एबे हमें केमती मॉलिक्यूलर मास कैलकुलेट करबा कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर मास केमती करबा देखो एट गिवन कंडीशन एट गिवन कंडीशन ताले कौन पाइले मास ऑफ वोलेटाइल सब्सटेंस मास ऑफ वोलेटाइल सब्सटेंस इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू ग्राम वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर प्रोड्यूस्ड इक्वल टू वीएमएल temperature equal to T degree Celsius which is equal to T plus 273 Kelvin and pressure equal to PMM and aqueous tension equal to AMM let it be V1 this one is T1 and P minus A that is dry pressure this is equal to P1 volume produced VMM this one is V1 room temperature T degree which is equal to T plus 273 Kelvin equal to capital T1 and total pressure is PMM aqueous tension is AMM so dry pressure that is P minus A which is taken as P1 and at NTP V2 we have to found T2 equal to 273 Kelvin and P2 equal to 760 mm this is V2 T2 and P2 we know a formula P1 V1 by T1 equal to P2 V2 by T2 implies V2 equal to V2 equal to P1 V1 T2 divided by T1 into P2 by cross multiplication we get V2 equal to P1 V1 T2 by T1 P2 put the values P1 is P minus A into V1 is V V1 is V into T2 is 273 divided by T1 is T plus 273 Kelvin into P2 is 760 After solving this one, let it be, suppose this become XML. This is say XML. Now, volume at NTP equal to XML. So, XML of air at NTP produced from W gram volatile substance, XML of air at NTP produced from W gram volatile substance 22400 ml of air at NTP produced from equal to W by X into 22400. This is suppose Y gram. Say it say Y gram. Now what is the molecular mass? Now molecular mass is, so molecular mass is YAMU. In this method we can calculate molecular mass of volatile substance by Hector-Mayer's method. Suppose I say one question by volatile method. 0.1 gram of volatile substance, 0.1 gram of volatile substance produces 106 ml of air at 27 degree Celsius and 710 mm pressure. Find molecular mass of volatile substance if aqueous tension is suppose 10 mm, this much, 0.1 gram volatile substance, so W equal to 0.1 gram, this is your solution, W equal to 0.1 gram, V equal to 106 ml, V1, then T1 equal to 27 plus 273 equal to 300 Kelvin and T1 equal to 710 minus aqueous tension 10 equal to 700 mm. These are your given condition at NTP V2 equal to question mark, T2 equal to 273 Kelvin and P2 equal to 760 mm. Now we know P1 V1 by T1 equal to P2 V2 by T2 implies V2 equal to P1 V1 T2 divided by T1 into P2. Put the values. P1 is 700 into V1 is 106 into T2 is 273 divided by T1 is 300 into T2 is 760. Now solve this one, let it be X. Now XML produced from 0.1 gram volatile substance and 22400 ml of gas produced from how much substance? That is the molecular mass. This finished your molecular mass chapter and next one is equivalent mass. What do you mean by equivalent mass? Equivalent mass. Short term the EQ dot mass, equivalent mass ke emti bhi lekhanti. What is equivalent mass? It is the number of parts by mass of an element which combines or displaces directly or indirectly 1.008 parts by mass of hydrogen or 8 parts by mass of oxygen or 35.5 parts by mass of chlorine. Meaning kon equivalent mass ame kahaku kahiba na 1.008 parts hydrogen jetti ki sangare misithibo or jetti ki ru bahari thibo 8 part oxygen jetki sangare misithibo bahari ki ru bahari thibo and 35.5 parts chlorine jetki sangare misithibo bahari ki ru bahari thibo sei ja ma taro molecular seta taro equivalent mass to pile aji to actually time he gola ni नेक्स्ट काली की नेक्स्ट क्लास को आप आपर को हमें आगेबा दैट इज इक्विवेलेंट मास चैप्टर को कंटिन्यू करबा ओके नेक्स्ट क्लास